number five, out on defense with Adam Foote. Cleared in, Domfus, nice move, shooting right on, they score!
And Hextall's wild again. Hextall going after McCreary big time. Claiming, I would think, that the puck was kicked in. Now, what does McCreary do this time? And it's good.
A goal.
Have you ever seen a finish like this?
Domfus with Muller. Vincent Domfus. Cross to Muller. Shot scores! Kirk Muller!
One shot, one goal for the Montreal Canadiens in overtime.
It's a lead pass for Savard. Just a stride too far. Kearney battling for it. They go crashing in. Ronan and Kearney. Here's a loose puck. Savard to Carpenter. They score! Guy Carpenter wins it for Montreal.
You have got to give Ed Ronan a big credit for this one when he wiped out the icing.
Once again, feeds the point. There's a shot. They score!
Everyone was still talking about Gilbert Dion's gesture after the goal in overtime of game number three. Dion twice pointed to his jersey to indicate that he'd scored the goal, when replays suggest that perhaps Patrice Brisebois' shot actually went in off Pat LaFontaine.
And I did score the goal. I know that for sure. I don't care what ESPN's been showing. Like I said to him, you should stick to baseball and basketball because they don't really know.
Cross ice pass. Daniel breaks it up. Here come the Canadians. Kirk Muller shot scores! Canadians win the series in four straight. Seconds into overtime. Kirk Muller's the hero. John LeClaire and J.J. Daniel get the assists.
Paredes keeps it in, and Brisebois clears it away to Domfus. Here come the Canadians, 3-on-2. Brisebois going to the net. LeBeau, the trailer, scores!
We talked about John LeClaire getting his first two playoff goals in game one. Stefan LeBeau gets his first two playoff goals tonight.
Domfus and Brisebois the assists. The Canadians lead 2-0.
An Islander knocked down, and here come the Canadians. Rene cross ice, Carpenter shot, scores! Guy Carpenter has won it for Montreal!
And what a heartbreaker for Al Arbor. The crowds in this building haven't seen this happen in overtime since 1979, did you say, Chris?
1980.
Rene carries in, rolling in front of the net, and shot! Desjardins following the play, and he missed in the short side, here he is again! Scores! Desjardins! And the Canadians win in overtime, his third goal of the game, and the series is a brand new one.
Clara will pick it up and come out for Montreal, out to center. Long shot by Bellows, didn't get too far.
Here's a chance for LeClaire! Oh, and a roll by the open side! He got another crack at it! He scores! The Canadians win the game in overtime again. This time, very early, 34 seconds, the Canadians win it.
Well, they have just done something no other team in Stanley Cup history has ever done, win 9 consecutive overtime games. They shared that record with the New York Islanders, and Harry, they've done it in 1 year. That's incredible.
Montreal, LeClaire coming in, gets it, he's in there. And can't get a shot, really beat it up, but he they score! The Canadians score, win the game! Another overtime victory for the Canadians!
I had pass on my mind the whole time. Their D have been dropping pretty much the whole game, so I thought if I faked it, I could get him out of position. When he did that, Kelly Rudy came on me, so I really didn't have a pass to Stefan LeBeau. I ended up behind the net with everybody out of the net, so I tried to jam it myself, and I got some help.